Hello friends, welcome to the CADCAM CAE lecture series. Today we are going to see the manual programming 5. Okay, in that we are going to see in detail about macro, which is also called as subroutine programming. So let's get started. So what do we mean by macro? Okay, it is generally used for repeating motion of tool. Okay, it is a form of parametric subprogram. It is a form of parametric subprogram used when similar operations but differ in magnitudes, that is location. So let's say I have certain set of instructions to be repeated, and in a program those instructions will be repeated several number of times. It is a requirement that those instructions needs to be repeated several number of times. Say for example, if I have again a pattern hole drilling of a certain kind, so the pattern involves certain circular patterns and those circular patterns are linear in nature. So let's say a set of 5 holes are repeating itself throughout the area of the plate, let's say. Then I can set it up as a subroutine program to drill those 5 holes in some sort of sequence and then repeat that set of 5 holes in the entire program as many times as I want. So what I will probably do over here is I will store the program, a short program which drills those 5 holes and I will call it as a subroutine program or a macro, and I will call that subroutine or macro in my main program that many number of times as I want them to get repeated according to the pattern that is required. So that is the usefulness of the subroutine or macro. So macro is a subprogram which is called by main program. So it's a subprogram which gets called by the main program, and such macros are stored in CNC. So the way your main program is stored in CNC, the similar way the macro is also get stored. The necessary macro can be called and the parameters involved can be supplied to a machine to machine the part. So you need to store the macro first when you are trying to call it in a main program. So it is just like a function. It is just like a function in your normal programming language. So you call the function in your main function and then the function gets executed, and again the call is shifted back to the main function and the rest of the main program is executed. So the way we work it out in any other programming language, similarly here also in terms of writing a separate program which can be called again and again in the main program, we use macro, or it is also called as subroutine. The necessary macro can be called and the parameters involved can be supplied to machine the part. When macro statement is issued in the main program, the machine control unit switches to the macro and it is executed. So the call is transferred to the macro when the macro is called in the main program. Then all the instructions written in a macro program are executed. And again, at the end of the line, the call is shifted back to the main program and the remaining lines of the main program are executed. At the end, the command is again directed to the main program. So if I see the syntax for the macro, it's fairly simple. The call for subprogram is a miscellaneous code. So it is M98. So when you write M98, the machine control unit understands that there will be a macro which will be followed by this M98 instruction, and P is a special character followed by the subprogram ID. Subprogram ID. So P1020. Now here 1020 is a subprogram ID. So 1020 is a macro basically. Then followed by L, which is a word address or a special character, and 1, that is number of times the subprogram executed. That number we have to write, and here since it is 1 written, so the subprogram will be executed only one time. Now what happens? The call gets transferred to the subprogram ID, which is 1020. And then all the instructions in the sub program will get executed. Okay, all the instructions in the sub program will get executed, and then at the end of that subroutine program, which is 1020, you will have an end statement. Okay, the sub program will not end with M30. Okay, M30 will always end the main program. Okay, subroutine program should always end with M99. Okay, should always end with M99. Now M99 transfers the call back to the main program, and it only ends the sub program. Okay, it only ends the sub program, and it transfers the call back to the main program. And from here onwards, the call gets transferred to the main program, and the next line in the main program gets executed. Okay, so we'll see one example. Okay, this is just a syntax. So you have M98 for calling the sub program, followed by the P, which is a special character, followed by the sub program ID, then L, followed by how many times the sub program should get executed. Okay, and when you are in the sub program, you can write instructions, and how you are going to end the sub program, you are going to end the sub program with M99. Okay, so let us take a very simple example. Okay, now here I have to drill these 5 set of holes. Okay, I have to drill these 5 set of holes total 3 times. So how I am going to drill this? Okay, the drilling cutter will come to the central hole first. Okay, then it will move to the top end, then it will come to this hole, then it will come to this hole, then it will come to this hole, then it will go to the second center hole. Okay, and the sequence will then continue. Okay, sequence will then continue. So what we will do is, okay, what we will do is, we will have Cant cycle. Obviously the macro is not going to work without Cant cycle. Okay, all these you can say the options which are provided, okay, to shorten the length of the program and to increase the productivity of the machine. Okay, these do loops, then these Cant cycles, and then these macros are provided. Okay, amongst all of these, Cant cycle is very important. Okay, so you have to have your machine in a modal command mode, which is a Cant cycle command mode. Okay, so whenever we change the coordinate, any which form, so let it be a do loop or let it be a macro sub program, okay, the Cant cycle mode should be on. Then and then only the machine control unit is going to repeat the motion. Okay, machine control unit is going to repeat the motion. So Cant cycle takes care of the Z motion, Z repeat motion, and macro and do loop takes care of the XY motion of the tool, just to position the tool above the drilling center. Okay, just to position the tool above the drilling center. So that is very important. What we are going to do in this manual program is, okay, the central holes we will drill with the help of Cant cycle. Okay, Cant cycle will always be on entire the length of the main program. Even in the macro also, Cant cycle will be effective. And these holes, that is this hole number 1, 2, 3, 4, so this is a repeat motion in terms of X. This is a repeat motion in terms of X. So once I drill this hole, okay, then I have to go top left, then bottom, then top bottom right, and up. Okay, so top left, bottom right, up. So top left, bottom right, up. Top left, bottom right, up. So this is a repeat motion in terms of X. Okay, this is a repeat motion in terms of X. So that I will be trying to capture with a macro. So here I will have to execute macro 3 times. Okay, and I will write the instruction sets in my macro in such a way that the tool will go to this point first, then this point, then this point, and then this point. So it will cover 4 drills in the macro. Okay, it will cover 4 drills in the macro, and then it will go back to the main program. Okay, drill this second central hole, again go to the macro. Okay, drill these 4 holes in the macro, again go back to the main program, then drill this third central hole, again go back into the macro, cover the remaining 4 holes in the macro, and then come out of the macro and come out of the program. So that is how the sequence is going to be. Okay, the plate overall dimensions 200 by 80, the holes are all 10 millimeter diameter. Okay, total 15 holes. Okay, their dimensions are mentioned. plate thickness is 20 mm, we are expected to drill all through holes. So let us just see how it is achieved. Okay, the sequence that I was talking about, we'll just see the video animation of this. Yeah, this is a central hole, then it goes back, drills those four holes in the sub program, again goes to the central hole, drills those four holes to sub program. Okay, and just to showcase, this is a through hole. Okay, this is a through hole, this is a through hole getting drilled. Yeah, so let's go ahead. This is a part program. So usually, okay, I have percent O, then the program ID, drilling cutter diameter 10 mm, HSS drill, that is T01. Okay, I have usual beginning of the program. So with the safeguarding I am doing, G00, G49, G40, G80, G71, G90. So it's a rapid mode, cancel tool length compensation, cancel cutter diameter compensation, and cancel any predefined CAN cycles. Okay. And it is going to be a metric programming and absolute positioning system. Okay, then I reposition the set point or home position with the help of G92, that is also possible. So I reposition the home point as X-40, Y-40, Z-20. Okay, then I change the tool to tool number 1, okay, M06 T01, and in a rapid mode I bring the tool above the first central hole location, so that is X30 Y40. Okay, X30 Y40. Then I switch on the spindle, that is 1000 RPM, and the spindle rotation direction is going to be clockwise. Okay, then G43 Z2 H1. So I ensure that cutter length compensation is on in positive direction. Z2 is set as the initial level. Okay, initial level, and the value is going to be stored in the reference register H1, and flood type coolant is going to be on M07. Okay, then I switch on the CAN cycle in the next line. So G81, G99. Okay, rewrite the central coordinates again, X30, Y30, Z-13. Okay, Z-13. Now, yeah, it has to be Z-23. Okay, it has to be Z-23 because the plate thickness is 20. So Z-23, R2, F-150. So field rate is 150 millimeters per minute. Okay, then M98. Here I am calling the sub program. Okay, so P1007. So my main program ID is 1006. My sub program ID is 1007. Okay, it will be executed one time. Okay, it will be executed one time. So the moment I write the instruction using M98, okay, M98, the program mode will get transferred into the sub program, okay, sub program ID, and the subroutine program is written at the below. So as you can see, I have a continuation program, and then I have in between written sub program, so 1007, and what happens is, then I will have new line numbers in for sub programs. So in 001, I am changing to the absolute, from absolute to incremental mode, so G91. Now what is happening, the current position, okay, current position, that is the central position, okay, central position of the tool is the origin position the moment I write G91. From that position, okay, the tool has to move minus 20 in x direction, and probably it is a plus 20 in y direction. So we'll just see. Yeah, so it is this is the central position. So this is minus 20 in x, okay, and this should be plus 20 in y. Okay, minus 20 in x and plus 20 in y. Okay, so here it will be plus 20. Okay, here it will be plus 20. Okay, then from there the first hole will be drilled. Okay, from there it will come down y minus 40. So vertically it will come down y minus 40. Second hole will be drilled. Okay, then it will go x 40. Third hole will be drilled. Okay, then again y 40. Fourth hole will be drilled. Okay, so in that sequence the holes will be drilled in the subroutine program. I am changing the mode to G90 to go back to the absolute mode again, and then M99. Okay, M99. So the call is transferred back to the main program. Okay, at line N040. Then again it receives the second central hole's coordinate. So X100 Y40. Okay, X100 Y40. Okay. So it receives the second central hole location, okay, and since it is already in cant cycle mode, so it drills this hole, okay, central hole. Again I am calling the subroutine program through M98. So again it comes over here, okay, in sequences it completes the drilling of those four holes. Okay, again it goes back to the next line, so that is N050. So you have X160 Y40. So this is the center location of the third hole. Okay. So third hole, third central hole gets drilled. Okay. And again I am calling the M98 P1007 L1. So again it comes into the subroutine program. It executes the drilling of those four holes in the same sequence. Okay. The call is transferred back to the main program. Okay. So then the next line, that is N060. I am cancelling the cant cycle because we have finished drilling of all holes. Okay, we have finished drilling of all holes. Okay, let us just go through this video sequence once again. See what we did. Central hole was drilled using cant cycle, and in order to drill these side holes or the holes which are around the central hole, okay, we use the subroutine program. So the sequence remained the same. This hole first, then second hole, then third hole, then fourth hole. Okay, yeah, this way. Then it came out. Okay, then it came out of the subroutine program. Then using the cant cycle, we drilled the second central hole, and again we shifted call back to the subroutine program, and we drilled the side holes again. Okay, in the same sequence. Again, it came out of the subroutine program. Okay, drilled the central hole and went back into the subroutine program to complete the drill of the side holes, and as you can see these are through holes. Okay, through holes. So I hope this part is understood. Okay, I hope this part is understood. Okay, as soon as we complete drilling of the all side holes, that is all 15 holes, okay, we end the cant cycle. Okay, we switch off the cutter length compensation. Okay, and we ask the tool to move up, okay, to the clearance level, that is Z20. Okay, we switch off the spindle supply, we switch off the spindle and we switch off the coolant supply. Okay, then in a rapid mode we go back to the set point or home point. We have already brought tool up to the Z20 level, so then I can only write X-40 Y-40 because Z is already 20, and then finally I can end the program. So this is an example. Okay, even though we have drilled 15 holes, okay, but see the length of the program. The length of the program is not much. Okay, even the main program is of very short length, short lines. Okay, so that is the use of subroutines or macros. Okay, they reduce the length and they achieve the maximum advantage of drilling pattern holes. Okay, using a very short subroutine program which is made to write with the help of the incremental positioning system. So here we use incremental positioning system in a very efficient manner, okay, to repeat the XY motion of the tool in as less number of lines as possible. So that is what these subroutines are used for. Okay, that is why these subroutines are used for. So I hope this concept is understood. Okay, I hope this concept is understood. We have seen so far the cant cycle, okay, for drillings. Okay, cant cycle for drillings. Then we have seen do loop, okay, with the help of cant cycle always. And then we have seen the subroutine or macro programming with the help of cant cycle. So this all activity was done so that we can write a program to drill pattern holes, okay, to drill pattern holes on a CNC machine, and the concept was established with the help of the subroutine programming, and in do loop also we made use of the incremental mode of positioning. So I hope this concept is well understood. Okay, I'll if you have any questions, you can ask me, or you can write a comment. Okay, and I'll see you next time with more such interesting content on the computer aided manufacturing and CNC part programming. So until then, thank you very much.